Danny, and today I'm filming in my new filming space. This is my sunroom. I'm going to film in here from now on because the lighting is just really, really good. So I've been wanting to film for a few days, but my video, I haven't had anything to film. Like, this weekend it is Sunday, the day before Memorial Day, and Sephora's having like a huge Memorial Day weekend sale, and they put like a bunch of random stuff on sale, and I did make two orders, but obviously I won't get those till next week. And then I recently bit the bullet and joined FabFitFun because their subscription service, like, I always watch the videos and they freaking rock. And you'll have more on that when I actually get my first box, but I'm getting the summer box, but I won't get it till 2 weeks from now, I think. Well, not really 2 weeks, a little over a week. It's like, I should get it on June 4th. I should get it on June 4th, so I'll have a video then when I get it, and obviously I made two orders from Sephora, so I'll have two videos then. And I've been thinking about something I could do, so I didn't really come up with it, I'm sure people have done this before, but I thought a cool idea would be to, like how some people do like beauty room tours or like the do declutter videos, and you can see like their whole collection. I thought it would be fun, and this is going to be a series, there's going to be parts, but I thought it would be fun to do that. So this is the first part of my show off, and this also show you how I store my makeup, because yeah, I don't have a lot of storage. This is my bag, and in this bag it has all my eyeliners, my mascaras, and primers, and setting sprays and stuff. I'm going to show you the bag, and I'll show you all the primers and stuff I have. The first one I have is this one, and I'll show you the stuff, and I'll kind of tell you like if I've tried it, if I liked it, and then there might be a little bit of decluttering. Like, this isn't intentionally an intentional declutter video, but there might be some decluttering. This is by YSL. This is just a sample of it, but this is the Touche Plot Blur Primer, and it was like a coupon code where if I spent so much money, I could put it in and get a... This is a really good sample too. You get a lot. And I thought it might be comparable to like the Guerlain gold primer that everyone uses. That's like $75. And I really want to try that one, but I haven't. I've used this one a few times and I really, really like it. But there's gonna be a lot of black eyeliners in here. I have this little tiny Makeup Forever Step 1 Skin Equalizer. I have this Hypnodrama mascara. Bought it from Lancome. I really like this. I have this little sample pack of Dip Brow Infuse. This is what it looks like, the Hypnodrama one. That smells a little funny. I think I have another one, and I'm going to smell it too, and if it smells different than this, I'm going to get rid of this one. So... Oh, I have this one. This is one of my favorite ones too. This is the Scandalized Retro Glam from Rimmel London. The one looks like that. It's a really fat one. I love this mascara. It's so good. I also have this Lash Blast Volume by CoverGirl. I haven't actually tried this one yet, so I should probably try that one. I have this little eyebrow pencil from Cello. In the color like Universal Taupe, Tantalizing Taupe. You can't even really see it. Oops. But I really like that when I actually put product in my brows, which I haven't been doing because I need to get them done. I have an Urban Decay All Nighter Makeup Setting Spray that I like. I've got this NYX Matte Finish Setting Spray. This, honestly, I used it a few times. I've had this for a very long time. It says 6 months on it. I've probably had this for 4 years. This is actually probably going to go away because it's ridiculously old. No, I've probably had this more than 4 years. This is ridiculously old, so this is probably going to get caught. I'm going to put it over here. I got this tiny Smashbox Photo Finish Primer, which I haven't tried yet. I have this Tatcha, the Silk Canvas Primer, which I haven't tried yet, but I'm excited to. have this Dr. Brandt Pores No More Primer. I have got this from Dr. Young Anti-Pore Pore Eraser Balm. It's like some kind of Korean thing. I got it a long ass time ago. But I think I might be getting rid of it. Maybe? I don't know. It doesn't smell off. I don't know. I'll think about it and then I'll get back to you. I got this tiny little Le Pore Professional primer. I have this NARS, the Audacious Mascara. I absolutely love this. I love the wand. I love this mascara. It's super good. I've got Urban Decay Perversion Mascara. This one, when you first get it, I think it's a little too wet, and it's also really messy because the brush is really fluffy. Whenever you put it back down, it like gets all over and it just kind of, I think it's probably better in the full size, but I think I'm gonna get rid of this little one because honestly I don't use it very much, and then like I said, it's really messy and the tube gets bunched up. I've got this Monster eyeliner from Artisty Inn. It's not bad. It's really creamy. Really black. This is a lot of black eyeliner. I don't have anything else. Oh, my other Hypnose Drama. Let me smell it and see if it smells different than the other one. No, they both smell the same. And this one's, oh, well, I'll keep them. I've got this little Milk Makeup Primer Stick. I've got this Bobbi Brown Smoky Eye Mascara. One looks like this. This one is really good. This is probably like in my top few favorites. Like, it's so good. I got this little bubble pack of Undercover Perfecting Coconut Face Primer. I don't know who makes that. Coconut Face Primer? Might be Marc Jacobs. This, I don't know why this is in here. This is a mini highlighting stick. This is gonna get moved to like my eyeshadow shoebox. That in mind. It just says primer, but I'm pretty sure this is the one that's from Rihanna's line, the Fenty Beauty line. This also shouldn't be in here. This is my Bright Future Gel Serum Concealer from Sephora in the color Parfait. It also should not be in here. There's a lot of concealer. Gotta put this with, this is supposed to be with my eyeshadow and stuff. Then I got this Lights Camera Lashes from Tarte. I don't even think I've opened this one before. It looks like that. Pencil sharpener. A Bobbi Brown gel eyeliner. I don't think I've used it yet. I haven't, and I really, really should. I have this one from Sephora. This is the Lashcraft Length and Volume one. Is this? Oh no, this one does too. Looks like that. Oh, fuck. Well, I just. Nothing got to the wand. Well, I know the formula's still wet because it landed on my arm and got all over my arm right there. Okay. I got this little tiny Lord and Barry Black Silk eyeliner. I don't know, I might get rid of it because right now it's a little bit drier than normal, but I will decide that later. I've got a Marc Jacobs black eyeliner. I'm on the fence about that one too. I got this Ofra brow pencil in brown. I'm gonna keep that because I only have like two brow products. I have this Ico Skinny liquid liner. Ooh. That is still wet, so I'll keep it. I've never really used it, nor do I use a lot of that, but whatever. Oh, and then I have this is a little tiny sample sprayer of the Kat Von D Lock It setting spray. I have this Makeup Forever Aqua XL Eye Pencil. Ooh, I like that one. It's right there by the that one. Alright. And then inside of here there's a little zipper pouch. And inside said zipper pouch, I've got a couple cards of Urban Decay eyeshadow primer and two of these eyeshadow primers. And I just keep my eyeshadow primers in there so I always know where they are. Like I said, I've been keeping my setting sprays in there and my face primers, because usually what I do with my face primers is I'll pick one or two. Currently it is the Tatcha one and the YSL one, and I sit them like on little dishes that I have. I have this little like catch-all dish and a little, like, it's supposed to be a soap dish, but it's really cute, so I keep it out. And I put certain items on there, like I have a foundation on there, and I have my primers, and I have a like a little tiny concealer on there, and I have like a face mask and a moisturizer. Like, they just kind of sit nicely on the vanity, and these are the ones I use for the time. And then I rotate them, which is why I haven't used a lot of these primers. This one I have used, and I like it. It's not bad. I haven't used the Sephora eyeliner, this CoverGirl eyeliner, or this Tarte eyeliner at all yet. I haven't used the Ico Skinny liquid liner, although it's still really nice. I'm going to use it. I really like the Monster. Yeah, Monster by Arzian. That one's really good. I really like the Cello Tantalizing Taupe Eyebrow Pencil. The Lancôme, even though it kind of stinks, the Lancôme Hypnosdrama Mascara is like probably one of my favorites. The Bobbi Brown one and the NARS ones are one of my favorites. This is also one of my favorites. I like the Ofra eyebrow pencil, it's okay. I haven't tried this yet, obviously it's a sample pack. This, again, I haven't really tried it. The Dr. Brandt one I haven't tried. I really like the Makeup Forever one. So, I mean, I like a lot of these products. I'm probably, like I said, only probably gonna get rid of a few handful of things, but that's my first video. And I hope you liked it, and there will be more in this series. And I'll talk to everyone later. Bye.